Hi, I'm Cindy, and I just got some awesome news from the Lord today. As I was seeking Him about direction and ordering my day, it seems like this week I've been really honing in. What am I doing with my time, Lord? And He was gracious to me today and told me He wanted me to start making these videos. I could hardly believe it because, quite frankly, I've been waiting 21 years to cast this vision. And I have been talking about it. My children used to laugh. You know, they're grown up with their own children now. I have six beautiful grandchildren. But they used to always say, Mama will always talk about the City of Refuge at least one time every day. And they were right. And here I am. Do you know that it's 21 years later since the Lord gave me the vision, His vision? He calls the Cities of Refuge. And just today, of all days, December the 4th, 2020, He says, I want you to start making videos and I want you to declare the vision. What? I don't know what timing God has, but He's got something planned for you. So here we go. I'm going to start telling you a little bit about it. Yes, yes, yes. I already wrote 3 books, right? How many of you have read them? No, He wants the vision out there. Okay, thank you to those 10 people that bought my book. I love you. For the rest of you, it's a page turner, okay? All right. There's a little bit in there that's, okay, the second book is full of history, but every single thing the Lord showed me is so valuable. And you too are going to just clamor for those books. Once this vision starts interacting with your life, you're going to be, oh my God, who was that woman and where are those books? I got to have them! So for now, I want to describe to you a little bit about what it's like to live under the bubble. Ooh, what is that? Live under the bubble? That sounds fun. And no, God is not making us all into bubble boys. You remember that poor guy, no immune system? God love him. Nope, that's not what the bubble of the Holy Spirit is. If you can imagine with me, and you have to stretch out your faith because this is so beautiful that everyone God reveals the vision to has a hard time believing that it's reality. They all think it's just their imagination, that God couldn't have something so wonderful, so fabulous, so marvelous for their lives. But I'm promising you that He does. And if your vision does not wow you, that you think, I can't do it, then maybe you are not dreaming enough with God. He said to me, dream with me again. It's almost like He created my whole life for all these avenues that just blend together to build these cities of refuge, to cast the vision, to encourage people that this is our future as the body of Christ. And as always, we have a choice to participate with Him or not. I can promise you, 21 years birthing a vision has not been easy for me. But where else shall we go, Lord? Only You have the words of eternal life. And He has so convinced me that this is the vision that He has for the body of Christ in the earth, that I can do no other, honestly. It's past, present, and future all come together in this vision. So what is the bubble? The bubble is a supernatural, invisible dome that is over a city, over a region, that is the protection of the Holy Spirit. It is a place with when inside the bubble, you are in a holy habitation with God. Now we have had visitations of God, but we've not really had a holy habitation of God. We've had glimpses. And in modern history, we can say those glimpses were the Toronto blessing in Canada. We can say the Brownsville Revival was a major visitation. James and Charles Wesley did the Wesleyan Revival. George Whitefield with the Great Awakening. You know, these things were sovereign, and they didn't just happen in America. There was the Welsh Revival. There was Ireland and Cumgall and Ireland and the monks, like 150 years, 24/7 worship and praise. There was the Moravians. And these places throughout all the earth, and yes, I have biblical scriptures in my book. Look at Ezekiel 44 and 45. It talks about a geographical region that God literally set apart for the priest. And what were the priests? They were worshipers. They were prayers. They sacrificed unto the Lord daily, relationship, face to face with God. God even said in the time of apostate, which, dear Jesus, I think a lot of the world is in another season of apostateness here. But in Ezekiel, there was an awesome time with Israel, and they had come back to the Lord. And this was the Lord's mandate. His verdict was, those Levites and priests that went apostate, I receive them and I forgive them. But they will minister to the crowds of people. But there's this one family of priests, the Zadoks. The Zadok family were faithful to me in the season of apostasy. They will minister face to face to me in the secret place with me, face to face. You know, I always ask this of people because we have to fight this movie star mentality in the world today. What is the greater calling? Is it to minister before crowds of people? Or a private audience with the king, a private audience with the president, which really shows the greater honor? You see, we need to lift our vision up about who we are in Christ. And your hiddenness is valuable to the Lord as mine is. Seek him daily, face to face. Worship the Lord Jesus. And he is preparing for you a city of refuge, a place of 24/7 worship and prayer, a place where missionaries come and go to the nations, a hidden place. And what God showed me about this bubble was so miraculous, I really had a hard time believing it for a while. And I'm going to be honest with you. I've ministered to hundreds, if not thousands, of people in my lifetime all over the world. And the last thing I want to do is to live in a community with a bunch of Jesus people who are just full of the flesh. You know, they bicker with each other. They're grouchy because they have to do their chores. They don't really sleep in late. They don't want to show up to Bible study. You know, I don't want to live with that. I want to live with the zeal of God burning in my belly. And I have to guard myself as you do. Hang out with those who are more mature than you, and you will be more mature. Hang out with those that are on fire, the fire of God burning in them, and you will get some of that fire. When you go to places that have the Holy Spirit moving in the anointing, the closer you get to the one ministering, you'll get more of it. I don't know what it is, but it's an impartation of God. And sometimes it's resident in the human being. And in times past, it was always like that. The closer you got to the minister, because they carried the anointing, that it would rest upon you as they laid hands on you. That's been that way for centuries, way before Jesus. It happened with all the great prophets, and certainly through Jesus. Do you remember the woman crawling on the ground? And he goes, "Who touched me? What was that? I felt something leave me." That was the anointing. Her faith reached out and she grabbed that and she got healed. The woman with the issue of blood had no bleeding no more after decades. So there is something to that. But God has revealed to me that there's something more, that he calls a holy habitation. He calls it a city of refuge. And if you will read in Revelation 21, it's very clear that this is the vision for the future of the body of Christ, whether it be in 50 years, 10 years, or 2,000 more years on the earth, this vision will come to pass. And God says, I will tabernacle with my people. I will be in a bubble. I will be in a secret place. I will be in a sheltering place with my people. And I will come down from heaven. And I will be their God. And they will be my people. There is a oneness in Holy Spirit that longs for us. The scripture says all the earth is groaning and longing for the manifestations of the sons of God. Rise up and believe with me that this is our future. It is a holy habitation that God has planned. And it's not just one geographical place. It is pockets all over the earth. Who knows if God won't join those pockets together for the new millennium in the future. I don't have the word of the Lord on that. But I do know this. He is building these places all over the earth. Some of them are called different things. Some of them are in their infancy. Some were forerunners like Kansas City and Moravian Falls that have gone out in the vision and are waiting, waiting like a pregnant woman waiting to birth. But I promise you this, it will happen. because it's not my vision, it's the vision of the living God. And this is something that is very, very important to his heart. What is it? To be one with his people. I love you guys. Look up into the eyes of Jesus and know that even though you seem to be losing everything and you're getting rid of all your superfluous stuff, you know, I've been in a big season of that, selling my property. Some people are buying RVs to live in. Some are finding it a hard time to make it financially. Others are succeeding, but that's life. Life goes on. What you need to do is get direction for your life. And for me, the question wasn't where, because I have asked him for 20 years, where, Lord, where can I build this? Where can we do this? And he has said to me so clearly lately, it's not about where we are, it's about who we are. It's about who he is. And he's a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. And he's a good, good father. Believe with me. And you can too have the kingdom of God on earth. Love you guys.